In this lesson, we'll talk about the reading settings that we find here under the Settings tab in the dashboard. So I've got reading already selected, and let's go ahead and talk about the first part of this, which is really going to be the deciding factor of what you want your web page to be, a blog or more of a just a dynamic web page that a company may have with pages itself rather than posts. Here's where we make the decision. You can either have on your front page your latest posts, where it would be more like a blog, and all of these new updates that you put up there constantly will be put on there, kind of like small little excerpts of something that you continually update if you're not familiar with a blog format. Or you've got a static page, which is going to be kind of like the typical home page you'd find on any kind of website that's out there, where it's going to have some information that may not change all that often. So you can choose here what option you want it to be. This is going to be for the blog. This would be for the more typical website here with a static page. And so if I were to choose static page, then I'd have the option of my front page itself being selected, and I can choose which of those pages that I have created. Now, on the default installation of WordPress, we have an about page, and so that would be my only option to begin with. But if I went over here and added more pages to this, I could select a different page to be my home page, or the front page is what they're going to call it here, rather than having a blog. I'm going to go back because I want this to be more of a blog for that first home page, or for those web developers out there, your index page itself that you're working with. So I'm going to go ahead and leave that as my latest posts as being on my first page that we get to. Under the syndication feed, it says show the most recent how many posts that we have. So if you have basically this feed is going to be for these news articles that are out there, or for these basically little applications that we have out there on the web that take all of your new content and then it puts it out there for people to read. And so right now it's going to show under our feeds that we have here, it's going to only show 10 of them at a time, which is probably, it's a lot, it just depends on how often you post, you may want to change this, but 10 is usually the pretty good default for us to work with. It says for each article on our feed, so whenever we have something listed in a feed, we have the option of showing the full text of everything that I write or a summary. So if you're writing these large posts, you may want to go back to the summary and only have kind of a small excerpt of it rather than the whole thing, or you can have the full text, especially if you're writing small little things, to show up for everybody. Just really is your preference what you like. For WordPress.com, these settings are going to be in our reading section. If you're not using WordPress.com, you won't see these, and I'll show you that here when I click on the other link here for another blog that I'm working on. The enhanced feeds are going to basically be what we have in each one of our feeds. We can show the categories or any tags we may have, or the comments, the number of comments. And this is a typical one because more comments that are seen on a particular post or on a feed, people who look at that said there's a lot of activity going on, there must be something important here. So you may want to have at least the comments count on there to show you how many comments you've got. You can definitely, it's your choice to take that off. So this is, again, a WordPress.com setting you'll find, but you won't find this on your typical hosted WordPress site. So let me go down here to follower settings, and you can see that if somebody wants to follow, now, and this is going to work in conjunction with the follow button widget that we can set up as well. So right now, you won't see this button on there unless we actually add that widget for the follow button. But we can make these settings happen here with anonymous followers, where it will show them the follow button, even if they've been logged out. Also, if somebody's following my website, especially through WordPress.com, they can also get an email anytime they choose to follow either the post itself or my entire blog itself. And so here are the two different email texts, the information that will be sent to them if they choose to actually follow my blog. And it says, howdy, you recently followed this blog's post, and then it just goes on to more information that's there. You can reword that to be more specific to something that's more of your character and writing itself. Same thing for the comment following an email text. It starts off with howdy, so you may want to change some of this information if you're using the WordPress.com's website. Let me go over here to, this is what the reading settings look like under my hosted WordPress site, and you can see where you've got the option still for your latest post or a static page. Now I have a couple other pages created here, and you can see you've got the option to choose whatever page you want. If you wanted it to be a static page, my suggestion to you would be to create a page called home or main or something like that, and then put your main or home content on that particular page and then choose it here for that one there. So that's just your own if you want that to be. That's just a suggestion for you. However, you've still got the blog pages that show up. 15 posts at most will show up on your blog page. And I may have not mentioned that. Let me go back here to this one here. Let's see, this one doesn't show you. You don't have that option on the WordPress.com. But here, under a hosted WordPress site from somewhere else, you can show how many posts appear on your, basically your blog page or your home page. Right now, 15 of them are designed to show up on mine. This is not the default number. So if you've got it hosted somewhere, you can make that something smaller. Maybe you only want 4 posts to show up. And this is where it's going to come into play, is if you are one of those people that like to have a lot of photos on there, you probably don't want to have a whole lot of posts showing up on each one of your pages, because it's going to take longer for those posts to load up. So really depends. If it's a lot of just basic text, you can have a whole lot of these posts. What will end up happening is eventually you're going to have more than 15 posts on your website. So if it gets to like 16 posts, you would see at the very bottom, you'd see a link to go to older posts or something like that, and people can click on and see those older posts that you work with. So this is the setting to show how many of those posts will show up on your website. It's interesting that WordPress.com does not give you that option here, but on a hosted WordPress site, it will give you that option of how many actually show up. So that's a big difference there between the two. Again, you've got your syndicated feeds, how many will show up in a feed option that you have there for anybody that's out there who's taking your RSS feeds or anything that you're working with and displaying them somewhere else, as well as you've got the option between a full text and a summary. Here I've got the option here for the encoding style. Most likely you're not going to be changing that. You're going to leave that the default. So these are the reading settings that you'll find here within WordPress. You may want to make some changes, especially, let me go back here to my latest posts. The biggest thing is going to be if you wanted to do a blog style web page or a dynamic or a typical like company website, your option is here to choose what kind of website for WordPress you want to set up.